What's got four wheels and flies? A garbage truck.
Hey folks, welcome to This Week in History. Let's do it to it. On June 27th in 1497, two leaders of the First Cornish Rebellion of 1497 were executed in London. And yes, that means there were two Cornish rebellions in 1497. See, the king had ceased tin mining, which was huge in that area, then levied ridiculous taxes to pay for military action against Scotland. Wasn't the smartest thing in the world. In 1556, the 13 Stratford martyrs who had been found guilty of being Protestant were burned at the stake on a single fire near London. One of the two women that were executed was pregnant, by the way, so I guess you could argue that it was 14. On June 28th in 1745, a New England colonial army captured the French fortifications at Louisbourg as part of King William's War. The location was rather strategic as it pertained to fishing and shipping. In 1776, Thomas Hickey became the first American to be executed by the colonial army for mutiny and sedition after a plot was discovered to cripple the Continental Army's war effort, including the assassination of George Washington. And of course, a shout out to our patrons, Steve Stevens, Clayton Jimenez, and Ebony Coleman. We appreciate your support, and if any of y'all out there want to support us, other than the ways you already do, with watching, liking, sharing, all that good stuff, just check out our link down in the description below. If you pledge $20 a month, you get a free t-shirt. Just saying. On June 29th in 1864, at least 99 people were killed in Canada's worst railway disaster after a train failed to stop for an open drawbridge and plunged into the Richelieu River below. There are believed to be as many as 457 people on board, so that's not a terrible death toll, all things considered. But 99 is still pretty terrible. On June 30th in 1882, Charles Guiteau was hanged in Washington, D.C. for the assassination of President James Garfield. Basically, old Charlie was crazy and believed that he was largely responsible for Garfield becoming president. He wasn't, by the way, and when Garfield didn't reward him for his help, Charlie decided it was time for the old lasagna lover to die. That's a different Garfield. Oh well. On July 1st of 1766, a young French nobleman named François-Jean de la Barre was tortured and then beheaded before his body was burned along with a copy of Voltaire's Dictionary of Philosophies nailed to his torso for the crime of not saluting a Roman Catholic religious procession in Abbeville, France. On July 3rd, 1754, George Washington surrendered Fort Necessity to the French, who had attacked in response to the ambush known as the Battle of Jumonville Glen. This was Washington's first shot at military leadership and the only time he would ever surrender. Also, these two battles would lead directly to the beginning of the French and Indian War. And that's just gonna about do it for this week. Sorry it was a slow news week, but we'll see you back here next week. Same squirrel time, same squirrel channel. Be happy, be healthy, and y'all come back now, you hear?